Tonight, live from Blackpool and the party conference, Labour and militant in debate. The issue, which militant supporters should the national executive of the Labour Party now choose to expel? Good evening. We're in the Winter Gardens, Blackpool. The audience are delegates to the Labour Party conference, where there has been a lot of talk about party unity and fighting the Tories. There's also been a lot of talk about militant. In that connection, there have been two key conference decisions. The conference gave its support for a register which would, in effect, proscribe the militant tendency, and the conference voted more right-wingers onto the national executive, which must now decide how many, if any, of the supporters of militant should be expelled. With me and representing militant, Peter Taff, editor of the Militant newspaper, and Tony Mulhern, prospective Labour parliamentary candidate for Liverpool Toxteth. Roy Hattersley and Frank Field were to have debated with them, but this morning they withdrew. However, MP Austin Mitchell and prospective parliamentary candidate John Speller have agreed to take part. Now, to set the scene, to find out grassroots opinion, we conducted our own public opinion poll of Labour voters through ORC, who did the poll after the key conference decisions. The sample of some 700 Labour voters came from 50 constituencies. We asked, would the Labour Party be better or worse off without the militant tendency? Better off said 53%, worse off 9%, and 23% said it would make no difference. Next, we asked, do you think there ought to be expulsions of militant supporters? Yes said 41%, no said 39%, a slender majority for expulsions, by no means decisive. And finally, we asked those who wanted expulsions, which of these militant groups should be expelled? The 8 prospective parliamentary candidates who are militant supporters, the editorial board of militant, employees of militant, rank and file supporters. And the result, 81% wanted the prospective parliamentary candidates expelled, 67% wanted to expel the editorial board, 66% the employees of militant, 64% rank and file militant supporters. Austin Mitchell, whatever people may think, whatever opinions may be, it is now for the national executive to decide what action to take. How should the NEC deal with militant?
Well, I think they'll deal with it effectively. I think what's happened now is that we've made clear the difference between militant and the Labour Party, that they are a parasite living on the Labour Party. They're different because their ideology is not ours. Theirs is an ideology of revolutionary socialism. Ours is one of moderate reform and reconstruction. They believe in a vanguard party which will create a revolutionary situation and then use it to seize power. We believe in taking power by winning it at the centre and in the localities and using it for the benefit of the people. The most important point, though, is that those ideological differences have taken organisational form, and that's what the Labour Party has quibbled at, and that's what it said is wrong by a majority of 3-1. The report, which was commissioned by the National Executive, carried out by Ron Hayward and David Hughes, an independent report, concludes that the militant tendency is a well-organised caucus, centrally controlled, operating within the Labour Party, and they are thereby doing two things. One is to infringe the party constitution. The other is to live a lie, because they are telling us that it is a newspaper, whereas it is in fact a party within a party. It has a central committee, it has branches, it has its own conference. It is organised as a very secretive conspiracy within the party. The interesting thing to me is they've never denied any of this.
So what
they've
action,
never gone what, to the trouble of explaining to the Labour Party what they're about. So what
taking
they should
that
do,
view, what should happen?
What they should do. We've made the difference clear. I think it's clear now that the head has to be lopped off. That means the central committee. The central committee. The people who are directing this conspiracy, who call themselves the editorial board, they are not eligible for membership of the Labour Party. They've excluded themselves by operating in this fashion. I think, secondly, that those people who are employed full-time by militant have the same relationship and should go in the same way. And thirdly, the candidates who have proclaimed their support for militant or who have organisational ties with militant should also go, because they are in a unique position. Candidates are the standard bearers for the Labour Party. We have to present the best possible, most attractive face to the country. They are not there to peddle like a chorus of 8 or whatever it is, their own ideology and their own set of views which are different from ours. So because of the standard bearers, they should now have their endorsement reviewed, and I think it should be ended.
John Speller, before I bring in Militant on this, is there anything that you wish to add as somebody who was the seconder of the motion on the register the other day?
Well, I think you said that the opinion polls talk to Labour voters, but there's an awful lot of don't-knows and an awful lot of people who are possible supporters of other parties who would be attracted to the Labour Party because of the government's record and are being kept away from that because of the operation of what they see as an undemocratic group. Because the Labour Party is a democratic socialist party that believes in change through Parliament. Militant is a Trotskyist organisation that does not. They believe in revolutionary organisations based on the model of the Communist Party in the Russian Revolution, and they despise democracy. Now, in a democratic society, they have a right. They have a right to set up that sort of body. They have a right to form their own party and to put it to the electorate and get the same sort of derisory votes that those sort of parties have always achieved on their own account. They do not have the right, as Austin said, to be parasites inside the Labour Party.
Right, well, can I now turn to you, Peter Taff? There's a long list of charges there, but significantly, Austin Mitchell is saying lop off the head, and there are two heads here that would come in that category. May I ask you, before you deal with their points, is it the view of Militant that they will seek to be registered, or would you regard that as a lost cause before you tried?
Well, we will have to reconsider our position in the light of the Labour Party conference decision. But I'd like to just really take up one or two of the points you raised in your introduction, and also the points that were raised by the two gentlemen on my right, one on the extreme right of this table tonight. And really, these gentlemen have tried to suggest that Militant is being witch-hunted out of the Labour Party because of organisation. Now, if that was the case, then solidarity, to which they subscribe, would also be up for expulsion from the Labour Party. Because solidarity, just a second, Austin, you've had your say. Solidarity is an organisation. Solidarity is an organisation with a membership, with a head office, with full-timers. Of course, it's not as successful as Militant. It can't produce a 16-page weekly newspaper. Now, the reason why this attack has been carried out, which I don't believe has the support of those workers who are acquainted with the ideas of Militant, is because of our programme. We support all the reforms in Labour's programme. A 35-hour week without loss in pay. A massive programme of public works. But we say that the next Labour government must nationalise not every grocer's shop, but the 200 monopolies that control 80 to 85% of the economy and introduce a socialist plan of production. If it doesn't do that, unfortunately, the next Labour government can create the disillusionment that the last Labour government created. That's why we lost the general election in 1979.
How are Militant going to react to what has happened this week? Will you go quietly? Will you fight? And if so, how?
We will not go quietly. We intend to conduct a campaign throughout the Labour movement, but let's be quite clear about it. The mood at this conference is for unity. You cannot have unity and a purge at the same time. You either have a purge, which will play into the hands of the Tory SDP enemy, many of whom shared platforms in Blackpool with Mr. Speller, and I don't know about Austin Mitchell, 2 years ago. You either have a campaign to defeat the Tories and the SDP enemy, or you have a purge that will play right into their hands. We intend to fight the Tories. We'll be on the picket line with the National Health Service workers, with other workers on strike. We'll be fighting for working people, but we'll also be fighting to make the Labour Party a democratic and a socialist party, and not a pale imitation of the Liberals and the SDP.
You'll be fighting to make... You will be fighting to make the Labour Party something the electorate of this country will not accept. Nationalisation of the 200 biggest companies has nothing to do with the Labour Party. And our policy is not nationalisation. We believe believe in the common ownership of the means of production, distribution, exchange. Now, can I get two lies out of the way straight away? One is Militant is not being expelled for its policy views. We all have policy differences in the party, and those policy differences should and must be argued out. If we didn't argue, if there wasn't a continuous discussion between left and right, this party would be dead. We must have discussion, and the left is essential to this party. It's when an ideology, which isn't ours, comes in an organised form, and it's the organisation that is the problem, this subversive organisation within the party. About solidarity. Solidarity does not have policies of its own. It has one organiser, and I can tell you, I'm the treasurer of Solidarity. It also has no money. The Militant has hundreds of thousands of pounds in loans from a company to keep the newspaper going. Where is that money coming from?
That's Tony Mulhern. Tony Mulhern has not
spoken yet on this issue, and I want to ask you, Mr. Mulhern, what is going to happen in your constituency and constituencies like it within the party if you and other Militant supporters are not endorsed?
Well, I've seen, and Labour Party members back in Liverpool have seen this week, an organised conspiracy of right-wing trade union leaders with the right wing of the Parliamentary Labour Party, which includes Austin Mitchell, conspiring in hotels in Blackpool and casting their votes against the wishes of their delegate conferences, against the wishes of their delegations, in favour of expulsions from the Labour Party.
It was 3-1 against you. 3-1!
The General and Municipal Workers Union, USDAW, the Transport and General Workers Delegation, cast their vote against their lay organisations who directed them otherwise.
Yeah. Austin Mitchell has been hammering the point that it is because of your organisation and not policies that you have been put into the position where you are now. Would you wish to take up those charges, that you are indeed a separate organisation, a separate entity, and as such of no place to
Labour Party? We've indicated from the word go that I am connected with only one organisation, and that's the Labour Party. And for Austin Mitchell to argue that we don't support the policies of the Labour Party from a member of Solidarity, who's his colleagues this week, after the vote on unilateral disarmament, a half an hour after that vote was carried, one of Mr. Austin Mitchell's colleagues went to the media and said that vote didn't matter.
I want to move on to the solidarity point.
On the other points, Solidarity is opposed to withdrawal from the common market.
We're not! That's
Solidarity,
ridiculous!
Solidarity is in favour of Vanguard's policy. And when that comrade on the end talks about Militant being in favour of a Vanguard party, he ignores the facts. Now, it may be a Vanguard party where he comes from, but in Liverpool, in all of the constituencies where Militant supporters have been selected as parliamentary candidates, the membership in those constituencies, in Toxteth, for instance, has increased by 150. In Brighton, Kemp Town, the membership has increased by 500. Tuesday, if I could just make this point, Mr. Tory, last Tuesday, we had a rally in Liverpool in support of the health service workers, in support of socialist policies, against the witch hunt, which attracted 3,000 people and which raised £1,700 for the Labour Party. Can any of Mr. Austin Mitchell's colleagues...
Everybody wants to get in on everything, and I'm going to have to make a decision. I want to put this point back to John Speller.
I want to put this to you, that Militant is, at the very least, an organisation of energetic and determined people. Isn't that a loss to that energy, something that the party needs, with an election coming up in a year or so?
It's an appalling thing in the way that they redivert the energy of many decent young people towards their own ends. At their Young Socialist Conference, they collect a few hundred quid for the Labour Party and thousands for the Militant organisation. And Tony Mulhern protests too much. He says he's only a member of the Labour Party. He's one of the shareholders of the organisation that funds the Militant tendency and funds their publication.
It's not true.
Tony Mulhern, shareholder of WIR.
Mr. Mitchell spoken twice. Can I just come in to correct some of the distortions, outright lies, actually, from the two gentlemen on the right? The money that comes to the Militant, every penny, comes from the pockets of ordinary working men and women, 99% of whom are active members of the Labour Party. Now, that's not true with right-wing organisations in the Labour Party who have had connections with organisations, unfortunately, financed by the CIA and financed by NATO. Now, the second point, more important, Mr. Toohey, is the question of how the Labour Party can win the next general election. Yes. Which both the gentlemen on the right have raised. Now, if you look at the record, look at the last local government election results. In Birmingham, where John Speller comes from, dominated by his friend Roy Hattersley, who refused to appear on this programme, by the way.
I made that point in the introduction.
He can go to the media and come out with all kinds of distortions about militant, but an open democratic discussion and debate he's not prepared to undertake. Now, in Birmingham, in the last local government elections, in that city, Labour went down to a defeat to the Tories. In Liverpool, where the policies of militant have a predominant influence,
the
a
Liberals
big influence,
still run it.
Within the Labour Party of Liverpool, there was a net gain for the Labour Party.
We are trying to address ourselves, amongst other issues, though, Peter Taft. We are trying to address ourselves to what the MEC is going to do.
Just conclude on the electoral
thing. Liverpool is a disaster area for the Labour Party.
Just very briefly on the electoral.
A city which should be dominated by Labour, with its huge unemployment problems and its working-class population, is in fact running a three-party system, and that's largely because of the growing influence of militant.
Whatever the record of militant...
Which is a tragedy
for the party. I'm sorry, Austin Mitchell, I must come in here. Whatever the record or the feelings that people have about militant and how it has behaved and what it is, the fact is that there is now a conference decision. It is down to the NEC to take action. At the same time, we have Mr. Tony Benn saying that we must see to it that nobody is expelled from the party in the next 12 months. Now, how can the conference decision be reconciled with that need not to expel people, not to uprise a witch hunt?
Yes, Tony Benn is not the majority of the National Executive Committee. The majority on the National Executive will make that decision, and there have been some very favourable changes on that National Executive Committee. And therefore, if it is necessary for the implementation of that decision for the full-timers of militant to be expelled and for the endorsement of the parliamentary candidates to be reviewed. And you say about the election being won. Militant had the candidate in the Euro elections in Liverpool, which is about the fourth save his seat, or should have been. They lost that election in those Euro elections. And if we are going to get across the real issues which are concerning people in this country, which is the rate of unemployment and the Tories' plan to demolish the welfare state, we have an absolute duty to put before the people of this country a party that is a credible democratic alternative.
Yes,
and
sir.
If it won an election, would carry out its policy in a democratic way, and if it lost the election, would also carry that out in a democratic way. And I'd like to ask Mr. Mulholland and Mr. Taff whether if Labour was elected on their programme, and it would take a long time and a lot of difficulty to carry out, would they, and it would be very unlikely and almost impossible for it to be so, would they actually, if they ever lost a subsequent election, hand over power?
Yes, of course.
No question about that, absolutely. And I could just remind you that Labour lost the last election on your programme. Yeah. Let's make it clear. I'd like to dispel some of the lies and distortions which have been made about the militant influence in Liverpool. The Liberals took control of the Liverpool City Council in 1973, when militant was unheard of. A year after, Mr. Austin Mitchell, people like him, in the control of the Labour Control Council, implemented the Housing Finance Act of the Tory government. That was the action of the right wing in Liverpool. The following year, the Liberals took control. And they moved into a vacuum which had been created by years of right wing neglect in the Liverpool City Council and in areas like Edge Hill. And let me make this point, Mr. Toohey. In the county elections of 1980, there was a big swing that Labour took control of the county council. In 1982, Liverpool was the only major city which recorded a swing to Labour, whilst in Mr. Spillar's area, Labour was devastated after him and his colleagues had carried through a programme of cuts in the Birmingham area.
One straight question to both of you. What will you do if you are proscribed?
If we're expelled from the Labour Party, that's not the end of the matter.
Well, Peter, why not give the information to the people? No, why not answer the questions about your organisation?
I've been asked the question
by
Mr.
Why not show us where the money comes from?
Look,
right.
The book's up.
Why not register?
Why
not register?
We've answered all the questions that have been asked about money, about full-timers, about the circulation of the militant. All of that, by the way, contained in the Labour Party conference report. Now, when you say what we should do about registration, the report makes it quite clear that if we try to register, we will not be accepted.
But, Peter, on the basis of the evidence you provided, that report says we believe that the militant tendency is not a group formed solely to support a newspaper. It has a hard core of supporters, including full-time employees, who form an organisation with its own programme and policy of distinctive and separate propaganda. You gave the evidence, and that's their verdict. Now rebut it.
Dennis, am I going to answer?
You answer the point.
The point being,
you did give the evidence, but that was the verdict on that evidence.
Yes, and we don't accept that verdict. And moreover, the rank and file of this party does not accept that verdict.
The conference
table. You spoke here today about a 3-to-1 majority. Now, how was that majority achieved? One of the leaders of one of the unions, Sid Wheels, it seems, calls in for flexible mandating. Because we have a National Executive Committee of the Labour Party that unfortunately now has been rigged. If the real views of the rank and file of the party were expressed, then we wouldn't have the present composition of the NEC.
Given the complexion that the NEC now has, can I put this question over here? Is it likely that the matter is going to be dealt with, and individual cases perhaps dealt with, and individual people dealt with sensitivity, shall we say, or is it likely to be a built-in right-wing majority vote, which will lead to considerable dissent?
It is important it's dealt with sensitively. I mean, militant is found on a lie, and they continue to lie about the nature of their organisation. It's difficult, this inquiry. It's very difficult. We don't want a purge. A purge isn't necessary. This is... Look, nobody on the left of this party is threatened in any way. The left is essential to this party. We need its contribution, its ideas.
So
what we don't need is an organised conspiracy which is constantly denouncing the party in a way they just have, constantly finding plots and betrayals, constantly besmirching the party in public and in their own newspaper, and constantly attacking the Tribune left and the left in the Labour Party, which doesn't belong to militants. It has to be handled with sensitivity.
Look,
we don't want to lose the idealism of all the young people in militant. What we do want is to get rid of the sinister conspiracy that directs militant. And that's the important thing. Make the difference clear.
Let him deal with those charges. Peter Tapp.
In everything that Austin Mitchell has mentioned here tonight about a conspiracy, about organisation, etc., there's not one iota of a criticism of the programme and the policies of militant. And that is not an accident.
It's your organisation we're objecting to.
That is not an accident. Let none of the working people watching this programme tonight be disheartened by what's happened at this Labour Party conference this week. What we have seen here in Blackpool is the rank and file of the party not prepared to see this party plunge back into turmoil. The Labour Party is a workers' party.
The Labour Party should
be reclaimed by the ordinary working people.
Yes, and it is.
It is infiltration.
Following that thought too, can I put this to you, Peter Tarr? If, as you maintain, your cause is the cause of the Labour Party and to work for the Labour Party, given the fact of the conference decision this week, why not accept it and why not work for those ideals which you say are the same as Labour Party's within the party?
It is possible. It's possible. Let me make it clear. It's possible in the light of the Labour Party conference decision, even though we don't accept the register, we still have the right to campaign against it. we will approach the NEC. We'll see whether we can come together to find some kind of arrangement. But I'll be quite clear. The sticking point, we're not prepared to give up a newspaper that adds to this movement and strengthens the Labour movement. We're not. And just the second point.
The only way in which the members of militant of the leadership will be able to remain in the party will be if they dissolve their conspiratorial Trotskyist organisation, which is totally alien. Totally alien to the views of the British working class will be reclaiming their party by the expulsion of militants.
That's all from tonight's TVI debate. From the Winter Gardens, Blackpool, good night.